Hello, everybody. Jeff Marr here, and joining me is Kelly Reyna, who we can now introduce as our newest STEM board member. Kelly is also a STEM parent. Kelly, welcome, and congratulations on the new role.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
So we're going to talk a little bit about your background and what you plan to do on the board of directors for STEM School Highlands Ranch and why you are pursuing this role. And really just what's ahead for you and our school. But first, let's talk about your background, both professional and personal, so that people have a better idea of what you do. I know that you have students at STEM.
I do, yeah. So we have been a STEM family since 2016. My son is now in sixth grade, so middle school, and my daughter is in third grade. We started when my son was in the second grade. So right when K-12 opened up the elementary side of it, we did have to leave, unfortunately, for about 18 months. My husband was transferred for his job. So we moved to North Carolina for about 18 months, but then immediately knew we were coming back and attended STEM right away.
And people are likely familiar with you already because you've kind of been a face for STEM. You've done some interviews for us and you've been in some promotional videos promoting STEM as a STEM parent for those who drop off and pick up their kids. When they pick up their kids, they likely see you in Driveline because you volunteer quite a bit. So some people might already be familiar with at least your face. Now they're going to be even more familiar with you in a more official role as STEM board member. So let's talk about that and why you decided to make that jump from STEM parent to now STEM board member.
Sure. Yeah. So I've spent the last 3 years on the SAC committee. So the student or the school accountability committee. And within that role, I've served as vice chair, chair, and again, vice chair. So that was a good stepping stone, I think, to maybe move into a board position. Honestly, I never thought that I would be there, but the invitation was offered and I saw an opportunity that we could potentially, as parents, bridge that gap between the board and the parent community. And I think that I could help with that.
Well, certainly it does help having a parent in that role. You have students who are your eyes and ears of what's happening in the classroom, and I'm sure they already relay things to you that are going well, things that could be improved, and maybe that will help form some of your initiatives and agenda of what you're going to bring to the board. And let's talk a little bit more about that. Have you formed any ideas or any pursuits that you would like to move forward on as you continue with your term as board member?
So a couple of things that have been a big focus the last couple of years is our school culture and teacher retention. So I'm excited to learn more of what position the board has in these areas and to see if as a parent member, we can make some movement in a positive direction with both of those areas.
And is there anything else that you would like to focus on moving forward? Any other ideas?
You know, it's all really new. So I'm one to really absorb the position. I'd like to learn. I'm not 100% sure what a parent role is. So I want to make sure that I understand that piece of it completely to better utilize my position. But being feet on the ground kind of parent volunteer that I am, I hope that drives the direction that the parents can go in. So I plan on continuing in the Driveline and on SAC. And I hope when maybe the new year starts that we can get back in the classroom because I really like to volunteer in the school and just be part of that culture and in that environment.
And let's talk about what STEM School Highlands Ranch has done for your students, as for your children. As I've talked about, you know, having you on the board, it provides an important perspective from the eyes of a parent. And having kids who go to the school, you kind of get a good idea of what the school is doing currently for your students' education. So how are they doing in their classes? How are they feeling being at the school?
So my kids are thriving, as most do at STEM. They just love the PBL learning style. I mean, that is a fan favorite of all of us. The fact that they can get their hands in it and really work on real world problems has been something significant for them. Some of my favorite things are my daughter did a marketplace in first grade, and she had to create a project, price the project, market the project, and sell the project for money, for virtual money or paper money. And that was just so cool. And my son has done a PBL on the pine beetle infestation in Colorado. So be able to put real world life has been really something great for them. They also really just enjoy the flexibility of the learning styles at STEM also. That's really important.
Well, your timing about the market is interesting, because we're actually doing that market again for first grade this week. So
yes,
really looking forward to that. And yeah, I think back to being in elementary school, and we did some lessons that were tied to that sort of thing, but definitely didn't have a whole market with the fake money and products and consumers and learning how business works. So I always am reminded of how special the school is every time I do a feature story in the classroom. So we're going to be showcasing that as well. Now, you did talk about your connection to STEM through your kids. Let's talk a little bit about your professional background. What are you currently involved in outside of school?
So professionally, I'm the director of operations and training for a 3-store multi-unit franchisee. It's Ideal CARSTAR Auto Body. So it's an auto body franchisee that I deal primarily with coaching, protocols. I have to make sure that the stores are operating, streamlining processes throughout each store continually. And then I work closely with the general managers and the owners to provide feedback and areas of improvement and such of that sort. So a lot of it is observing, and then advising is a lot of it. And then of course, training and teaching.
So let's see, you're a mom, you serve on a committee, you're now a STEM board member, you're also involved in that business that you just spoke of. So you must not have enough hours in the day.
We make time. We make time for everything. Moms are rock stars. Yeah. All the moms out there.
Absolutely. Well, I know that I can speak on behalf of all of us at STEM, just that we greatly value and appreciate your presence at the school in any capacity. So do you have any closing thoughts or closing philosophies that you would like to leave people with? Because I'm sure we'll be talking to you more as you learn more about this role and what it's going to do for the school.
Yeah, so I guess my biggest thing is I do know many parents out there, and I'm hoping that having this board position will open up the door, the communication doors for other parents that I don't know. So if anyone has questions, concerns, celebrations, and you just want that parent connection, please reach out to me. I'm so eager to get to know more parents and be able to bring that back to our board. It's quite exciting.
Absolutely. Well, Kelly Reyna, thank you so much for joining us and giving us some of your time and input into this new position. We certainly look forward to seeing you advance in this role, and we'll certainly be following up with you as well on different issues that come about. So congratulations.
Okay.
And thank you again.
Thank you so much.